So I at least think it's pretty obvious that Tony Prince from The Ballad of Gay Tony is going to be making a return in the Grand Theft Auto Online Nightlife DLC. Not only did Rockstar hint at it a handful of times in the trailer itself, whether it's a sign on the side of the nightclub that says Tony's or whether it's literally showing him leaning on one of the handrails, having a drink in the nightclub itself, or whether it's describing him on the Newswire post in which they announced the trailer, I think it's pretty obvious that he is going to be the guy that leads us through our nightclub business. But he was really only one third of the main nightclub trio in The Ballad of Gay Tony. We're missing Luis Lopez and Yusuf Amir. Well, is Luis Lopez in the nightclub trailer too? That's what we're going to be talking about in this video today. So yesterday, one of my followers on Twitter, MikeMoney500, tweeted at me, "Is this Luis Lopez?" And he sent me a screenshot of the nightclub trailer. And I'll take you guys to the exact part of the trailer in which he's talking about. So he's talking about this part right here. It's like right as the names are going on the screen, Solomon, the Tale of Us Dixon. And he's actually referring to the guy not on the very far right, but sort of on the right-hand side. Now, a lot of people are saying that this is Luis Lopez. Let's talk about why. There's three things that you could say give this away. Number one is the haircut. Luis Lopez had a very distinct sort of military-style haircut. We'll talk about that in a little bit, but in case you guys didn't know, Luis Lopez was ex-military, so his haircut is high and tight. It's very iconic. Number two is the collar of his Letterman jacket. His default outfit has him wearing a pair of jeans and a black and white Letterman jacket, sort of like a bomber jacket. And at the very top, it has these black and white stripes, which you can kind of make out in the trailer. And then the fourth thing is the jacket itself. The main part of the body is black and the sleeves are white. Again, a very distinct look. And as you guys can see right here, if we sort of do a comparison shot, you can see that all sort of those features match up, and it really does look like that is Luis Lopez, at least according to the haircut, the collar, and the jacket. Now, once again, this is only from one point of view, and it is kind of hard to tell because with all the strobes going on and, you know, how fast the trailer was moving, it's obviously not in perfect clarity. And I want to talk about why this might be Luis Lopez, and also sort of debunking why it might not be him as well. So why could it be Luis Lopez besides everything else I mentioned? Number one, he was a huge part of The Ballad of Gay Tony. Not only was he the protagonist, he's the bodyguard and business associate of Tony Prince. So there's a good chance that because Tony Prince is in the nightclub update, Luis is probably sticking around helping him out. Also, fun fact, in Grand Theft Auto 4, he's 25 years old, and since we know GTA 5 takes place about 7 years later, roughly, depending on what timeline you know, Luis would be in his young 30s, so he certainly wouldn't be too old to partake in anything that's going on. Now, what about the events of The Ballad of Gay Tony and the ending? In the very last cutscene of the mission Departure Time, Luis is thanked by Tony as he saved his business. Then Yusuf Amir arrives, and the three talk about what their future holds next, as the player decides to see what will happen. Now, it is implied that they finally accept Yusuf's offer to franchise the Masonette 9 and Hercules nightclubs, although it is never explicitly stated whether or not this happens. So, we have to assume, since Tony is here, that the deal did go through, and that Yusuf and Luis and Tony partnered together to franchise nightclubs. That's why he's appearing in Los Santos. Now, sort of a side point to this entire situation, what if Tony Prince is not the only returning character? What if indeed this is Luis Lopez, and what if Yusuf Amir is tagging along as well? Now, I was trying to look for him throughout the entire trailer. Again, it was moving so fast, it was kind of dark, and I didn't spot anyone that quite resembled Yusuf Amir. But it certainly would not shock me if he was involved in this transition as well. Now, let's talk about why it might not be Luis Lopez. Now, since we don't hear anyone speak, or since Rockstar never officially mentioned that Luis, or even Tony for that matter, was going to be arriving in this update, we sort of just have to look at the character pretty closely to determine if that actually is Luis Lopez. So I know this might be a little bit difficult to see, and of course I am just playing devil's advocate here, but what if those white sleeves aren't sleeves, but instead it's a sleeveless shirt, like what we saw Rockstar add in the Gunrunners DLC and even continue to throw out in the Smuggler's Run DLC. So again, it is a little bit hard to see, and obviously thanks to the fact his sleeves are white, it's kind of hard to tell, you know, whether they're arms or sleeves. So I'm really not too sure here. We also get another angle of, I think, this character once it actually flips over here. You guys can actually see him dancing next to Tony Prince. We know that's the exact same stage because the girl to the very right of Tony is also featured in that shot before. And this is the shot where it starts to look a little bit less like Luis, in my opinion. So you guys can see he is wearing a chain of some sorts, and I'm not sure if he has a watch on too. I know for a fact that at least in Grand Theft Auto Online, if you're wearing a watch, like you can't have a long sleeve shirt on, like because of the clipping, Rockstar won't allow you to do it. So I can't tell. It almost looks like it's a generic Grand Theft Auto Online NPC. I am really on the fence here. I am not sure, but this also confirms sort of the bottom part of Luis Lopez's outfit, if indeed this is true. Because the bottom part of Luis Lopez's outfit was him wearing jeans and regular sneakers. And that looks to be what that character has on as well. So from the front, I don't know if it helps anymore. One thing that is kind of interesting is you get to see what gay Tony Prince looks like from the back as well. So this shot you guys are seeing right here is the exact same shot that we actually see when it zooms in on the front of him. It's just taken from a different angle. So you can sort of see the back of his suit. You can see him sort of waving his head back and forth, just sort of like what he's doing when he's leaning on the rail up there. So is this Luis Lopez, and are we going to see him featured in the Grand Theft Auto Online Nightlife DLC? I certainly think it's a possibility. I'm like 60-40 split here. I think it is him, but by a slim margin. Again, the trailer made it really hard to tell, which is unfortunate, and Rockstar probably did that on purpose. And if both of them are here, I certainly think there's a possibility that they could complete the trifecta and have Yusuf Amir appear in the trailer as well. So I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Let me know if you think this is Luis Lopez, or do you think it is just a random Grand Theft Auto Online NPC or one of the online characters? Because what I saw a lot of in the trailer is there didn't seem to be a lot of NPCs. It seemed to be a ton of actual online characters dressed up in clothing that we can wear. So let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. Do you think this is Luis Lopez or not? If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And also, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily GTA 5 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.